Las Vegas rocks all around the clock. Las Vegas rocks, 'cause this town never stops. Las Vegas rocks all around the clock, 'cause this town never stops. Las Vegas rocks.
That's right.
It's the Las Vegas Rocks radio show, the show before the show. Join us for a fast-paced hour of celebrity interviews and entertainment news. And now, here's Ron.
Well, Las Vegas Rocks!
Hey, everybody, welcome to the Las Vegas Rocks radio show. As you can see, we have one empty seat right there. It's Hal Savar. And he was stuck in a traffic jam somewhere. So were you, Sam.
I was.
On Blue Diamond.
It's not a Jewish holiday, you know, where they leave an empty seat and the door open for Eliyahu.
I know nothing about Jewish holidays.
I don't either. But
yeah, what do you got with that?
That's all I got.
That's it, huh? Okay.
I don't even know what it means.
Anyway, Tom Hillery's here with us. Hello, Tom. Tom, he just sent a text, Hal, that he's in the parking lot. That's what I was telling you.
He's in a parking lot. I'll open the door for him. It's easy enough.
Okay, just keep an eye out for him. We'll have Hal here in just a moment. But first up, let's talk about who's here with us right now. So join me, co-host, resident genius over at the Portnoy Gallery, Mr. Neil Portnoy. Everything's going good?
Everything's going very well.
Along with Tom Hillery, our executive producer and movie maker, and you're now casting your latest movie, Tom?
Yes, time to stop talking. Got the money raised for Honey Trap, and we are doing the casting this week.
Okay, and tell us in a little while what Honey Trap, give us a synopsis or whatever they call it. One sheet. A treatment.
A verbal one sheet. Gotcha.
A verbal one sheet.
You got it.
And make sure you say the word sheet very carefully, if you don't mind. And direct from his appearance on Inside Edition on Channel 13 here in Las Vegas, he was on just the other day. A great guy. He's got a lot of credentials here that I've been reading about. But let's welcome to the studio the deputy editor of Vegas 411, Mr. Sam Novak. Hello, Sam.
Thank you. Hello there.
And phoning in today around 5:15, we're expecting a phone call from Adele. So,
really?
No, we are. Yeah, I'm not Adele.
Oh, that's a surprise.
At 5:15 today, we'll have a phone call from Adele, and we'll see if she actually.
You heard my joke earlier. Can I repeat it about
Does it have anything to do with the phone call from Adele?
It does. What does Adele and Dolly Parton have in common?
What's that?
They're both upset with their sets.
There we go. It's real radio, Neil. You know this is.
Well, that's why I asked.
Oh, it's okay. No, it's okay. That's right, 5:15. We're going to hear from Adele on the phone.
I can hardly wait. I guess I'm going to be hung out to dry.
Yeah, well, we're going to talk about this and some of the things that you know about on your Vegas 411. There's a lot going on backstage and on the other side streets, let's call it, whatever's going on down there. And also some shout-outs, right, before we go into that. And we're still waiting for Mr. Savar.
I got an eye on the door.
Okay, good. We'll shout outs today. First up, Tammy, my love. Hello, honey. She's at home listening to the show or in her car listening to the show. Say hello to Marty Carmo up in Reno. Hello, Marty. How you doing up there, my friend? And Barbara Brighton.
Barbara.
We keep doing a silence thing on Barbara, but, you know, poor Barbara. She's doing Zoom work in Florida.
She's in Florida doing Zoom work or she's here doing Zoom work to Florida?
One of those. It's one of those. We have to check and see what it is. One of those. And let's see who else we got on the list. Hello to Janet Conway up in New Jersey and Gene Ferrari. Gene Ferrari is making an appearance in March in Florida. We'll talk to, we'll play some Ferrari music tonight. Hello to Ninon. Ninon is a lot of fun, and she's doing her show now from Salud.
Oh, she's in Salud.
Making a Mexican restaurant.
Is she doing the senior tour? Because she keeps moving to different locations. I'm asking for a friend.
I don't know. I think she's going from one bar to another.
That's what I mean. Yeah.
You know, I like to have a job like that. Go Las Vegas Live. Oh, Go Live Vegas, rather, with Aaron Elegus and Raquel Elegus. Thank you for carrying the show across the world on your great app. Jerry Walker, my buddy up in Reno. Jerry is selling insurance. He wants everybody to know you need to have insurance.
Yes.
Okay. Okay, Jerry, you need to have insurance. Out roaming the desert in his RV are PJ Gia Maria. Hey, PJ and Mar, how you doing? They're out there having a good time. Hello to everybody at the Italian-American Club. We all work there, apparently, from time to time. And we want to say hello to Jimmy, Ben, and Angelo. And Janine.
Pritchard,
yeah. She does a lot of work. Have we had anybody arrive yet? No. Must be in the wrong. He sent me a message. I'm in the McDonald parking lot.
He didn't tell you he's in line to get a Big Mac.
I guess so, but he's in the wrong parking lot, apparently.
There was somebody parked right next to me that was having a Mac.
Was having a Mac.
Even him?
The Mac attack, right? Who else is out there? Tommy Ronca in Maricopa, Arizona. Anna and Paul Rosenthal at NV Star Ticket Distributors and Tour Distributors. My cousins in Florida. Let's get the names right. Diane, Frank. That's it. No, Michelle. Diane, Frank, Michelle.
Just keep throwing
Susie.
Names out. There's a lot of Italian relatives of yours.
And Richard.
And Richard.
I got them all. And my other cousin on the other side of the coast, Lou Rosano. He's a friend of Brian Nofel. Let's say hello to Brian.
Hey, Brian.
Hey, Brian. How you doing? We're going to bring him in here next week to take some pictures.
He's great.
He's great. And also, I'm sorry to say that we're celebrating or remembering Tony Sacca on the 31st on Monday. It was the fifth anniversary of his passing. And also, they're in project now. There's a new project. Josette LeBlond and Nazara Coffey are doing a new Tony Sacca project. And they're looking to make a half-hour show. I'm going to help them with it.
Is it going to be in French or English?
It's going to be in Frenchlish.
So, in other words, she's not in it because she can't... well...
No, she's not in it.
Yeah, she speaks Frenchish.
She's not in it. But Tony Sacca's in it, and we're producing it, and it'll be in honor of him. And we're going to play it back at 11 o'clock on a Sunday, where Zaina Juliet has her TV show, and she's graciously giving up the time.
Oh, nice.
On February the 20th, which is his birthday, to play a memorial for Tony. So it should be a lot of fun.
Quick shout-out to the lovely Dorothy.
Yeah, anybody else?
No.
Nobody else? That's it?
Not this week.
Okay,
I've got nobody.
You got nobody? Nobody at all. Okay, so...
How about Tom's 12 girlfriends? Can he shout out to them? They're like your Italian cousins.
How many girlfriends?
All at the same time.
How many girlfriends, Tom?
Only one that counts.
The only one you can talk about.
That's Janice, yes.
Yeah, I know.
Shout out to Janice.
That's right. The only one you can talk about. So we're going to take a break right now, and going into break, I've got...
Perfect timing.
He's arrived. He has arrived. Let's take a break. Here's Celine Dion. It's All Coming Back to Me Now. We'll be back with Mr. Savar and Mr. Novak. We'll be right back.
I tossed into dust and I just knew my eyes were drying up forever. I finished crying in the instant that you left, and I can't remember where. Hold me like that. I just have to admit that it's all coming back to me when I touch you like this and I hold you like that. It's so hard to believe, but it's all coming back to me. It's all coming back. It's all coming back to me.
I'm attorney Paul Powell. If you get hurt in a crash, did you know your lawyer can take more money than you? That's right. You get hurt and the lawyer gets rich. Not very fair, is it? When you hire me, those worries go bye, bye, bye. I promise never to take more money than you. I put it in writing.
If you're tired of greedy lawyers, call 728-5500 or go to paulpowell.com.
I really can help.
Paul Powell.
More lawyer, less fee.
Some restrictions apply.
Do you like taking your car to a shop for maintenance or repairs?
Huh, are you kidding?
Exactly. That's why people all over Las Vegas are using RepairSmith. RepairSmith will do all your car maintenance or repair in your driveway, safely, with no contact.
RepairSmith works on my car at home?
Anything your car needs. Oil change, battery replacement, or brakes, you name it. From regular maintenance to major repairs, RepairSmith will do it all at your home.
What kind of cars?
All of them. RepairSmith has specialists for every make, year, and model of car. Foreign or domestic.
Expensive?
No. You'll pay the same you would at a local shop. And you even get a guaranteed quote before you book. No surprises.
Life just got a whole lot easier.
To get a free quote, plus $25 off your repair, and to schedule at-home car repairs, go to repairsmith.com and enter code QUOTE. That's REPAIRSMITH.com code QUOTE. Repairsmith.com, code QUOTE.
There's no other place like Las Vegas to see. No other place like Las Vegas to
be. And we're back on the Las Vegas Rocks Radio Show on AM 670 KMZQ. I'm Ron Garrett, and with me, my great guest today, Sam Novak. Hal Savar. Hello, Hal. How was the traffic?
Vegas.
Vegas traffic. What does that mean, Vegas?
I don't know, you know.
Vegas traffic.
It's always a gamble.
Yeah, it is. Where you coming from?
Nice.
Oh, boy. You're stretching. Is that a new song?
Yeah.
You drove in from where? Where were you,
Cheyenne and 215.
Cheyenne and 215.
Yeah.
See, people, the town is a little bigger than it used to be. It takes some time to get across town these days.
That's 25 minutes from there.
Yeah.
25 minutes.
Excuse me. I got a little bit hoarse going on here. I got a little hoarse.
Yeah, I'm in Rampart Lake Mead, so it's about 20 minutes from me.
Where'd you come from, Sam?
Blue Diamond and Fort Apache.
By the way, Hal, we're waiting for a phone call here at 5:15 from Adele. So let's see how that goes. Huh? What do you think?
I'm happy to be here for that.
Yeah, we're going to have Adele on the phone coming up in just a few minutes. Let's see how much time.
That's awesome.
I'm all excited about it, you know.
Can't you see my enthusiasm?
Oh, you're jumping out of your skin.
I can't believe this is happening.
Okay, Sam, you're a writer. Let's tell everybody about Sam Novak, okay? You're a writer.
I am.
A fitness advocate. A proud dad.
Stand up straight.
Of cats.
Indeed.
A cat dad. You're a film fan, so you and Tom might have a few things to talk about.
Yes, we've crossed paths, I think.
You're the deputy editor at Vegas 411. You have a little deputy badge you wear or what?
I do. Well, yeah, but there's nothing to pin it on.
No?
Because I'm usually bare-skinned everywhere I go.
Yeah, I saw some of your pictures. Yeah. I see that. Yeah.
Sorry.
Yeah. When Neil Portnoy'd you, and I said, is that really his body underneath that?
And I said, yes.
And it was.
I would pin myself.
If you had a tire pump inside my ear, maybe.
No, you work out hard. You must. Every day?
Pretty much.
Every day.
Except for today.
Yes, you didn't do it today.
I skipped it to be here.
You were out late last night.
I was out late last night.
That's what happened. Well, let's see what else you do here. Let's see. You're a reporter for the Chic Compass?
Chic Compass Magazine. It's
Chic
Compass
Magazine.
It's a fashion magazine based in Vegas.
Yep.
It's got entertainment, dining, things like that. It's pretty new, but very, very classic.
Now, you're from Pennsylvania near Pittsburgh. How do you pronounce that?
Aliquippa.
Aliquippa Poopa Papa.
Which was a Native American queen.
I would think that was an Indian background. Can we say Indian on the radio anymore?
No, you can't.
Native American background.
Yeah. Okay. We that's what it is.
What's the name of the town?
Aliquippa.
Do they have the Aliquippa football team, like the Washington football team?
They used to be
the Redskins. You were probably the Redskins, but they changed the name.
We were the Aliquippa Indians for a while, and now we're the Aliquippa Quips.
What are the Washington football team is going to be called? The Commanders.
Oh, it is.
The Washington Commanders.
Works perfectly in Washington, D.C.
They should have called them the Washington Sentinels, like they did in the movie...
What did you say? The Sentinels.
Sentinels.
Oh, I got the
Sentinels,
letters
like
mixed
a guard. This Washington Sentinels. That's the name I came up with.
I like it better than what they use.
Yeah, well, that's all right. The Commanders. You lived in Fort Lauderdale. Yeah. You lived in Oregon, in Northern Oregon.
Mm-hmm. I actually still have a house in Oregon.
You've done a lot of work. And you also were just recently on First Edition.
Inside Edition.
Inside Edition, I mean, talking about Adele. Well, fortunately, right now on the phone. Waiting for me to talk to her. I think is she here? Is she on the phone? Go ahead and bring that up for me. Hello? Hello?
Hello?
Hello, Adele.
Hello, Ron. Hello there.
Hello, Adele. Thank you for calling in.
You're welcome, Bob.
Not Bob. Ron.
Oh, I'm sorry, Rob.
No, not Rob. Ron. All right, don't worry about it, Adele. Tell us, what the hell happened at Caesar's Palace? What was that all about?
Well, I can't swim.
You can't swim. I heard, Adele, that you called the $1 million pond feature a baggy pond. What's that?
Well, no. I was talking about my hairdresser. She's getting quite old, you know.
Well, one more thing, Adele. Do you mind singing a little bit for us? And do you plan to come back to Las Vegas?
No and no. All right, Ron.
Ron.
Here's my latest hit, Ron.
Oh, go ahead.
I think you may have heard. I was opening the show with it, but... There ain't no gold in this river that I've been washing my hands in forever. I know there is hope in these waters.
Okay, Adele, thank you so much. Adele, thank you. It was fun talking to you, Adele, on 670. Hey, Adele. You're singing longer than you did at Caesars right now. It was really fun talking to you, Adele. Thank you for listening to AM 670 KMZQ.
AM radio. Oh my God! So small time. Why am I even talking to you?
What? Hello.
She hung up.
She hung up on us.
She hung up.
Is BB doing new voices now?
No, that was Dana Daye.
She did a great job.
Didn't she do a good job?
She did a great job, yeah.
We're only kidding. Obviously, Adele's not calling the Las Vegas Rocks radio show.
She wouldn't call if I was here, I don't know.
Probably not. Dana Daye, thank you so much, Dana. You did a great job. Let's hear it for Dana.
Yeah, great job, Dana.
Of course, you guys were all fooled, right?
Absolutely.
Yeah. I'm waiting to hear Sam's story about Adele because I know he's got a little bit of story about Adele that something it sees is something for us.
The one thing that I was able to say on TV.
Thanks again, Dana. I appreciate the call in. Go ahead, Sam.
That really didn't get out and about on all the other reports was her fussing about the curtains.
The curtains.
It was an issue of velvet.
Mm-hmm.
The pawn issue. Absolutely true. But she was bothered by the shimmer of the curtains behind her. They didn't have enough glisten to them.
Now, where'd you get the info on all this, Sam?
Oh, if I was to tell you this, I would implicate the person who was...
No names. You've been backstage. You've been talking to the right people, right?
Trust me that the person who told this to me was right there in the thick of things.
Mm-hmm.
And there was a lot of arguing between Caesar's people and Adele's people, like almost physical confrontations with standing up and fingers in face.
Wow.
No kidding.
Yeah. And
what was with the pond? What is it? Was it some kind of floating thing?
I don't know if you ever saw Kylie Minogue's show in the Coliseum, and it had a kind of a similar feature where she was surrounded by all of these dancers, singers. Mm-hmm. And she was in the middle of it. It was almost like a fountain. I'm not sure exactly if this was going to be the same kind of thing. I don't know if they even recycled some of those sets. From what I understand, they were all built custom for this.
So what do they do with them now? I mean, I was thinking about it. I'm watching on the video. There's trucks pulled up.
Loaded out back to Fresno where they were constructed.
So they go into storage there?
Mm-hmm.
Never to be used again.
Never.
What do you think happened to Neil? You think that she just freaked out or what?
I think it had to do with what we're all dealing with in the world, with masks and COVID and you know, getting backlash for ticket prices. I think that had something to do with it. Her fan base was not happy.
But they paid.
They paid through that.
Well, the suits paid. The suits paid.
Well, first of all, the first couple of shows are probably all corporate anyway. Everybody Correct. That Caesars, works for Caesars was going to be there for
Correct.
That one. Without a doubt.
Hmm.
Well, they get the A seats anyway, you know. But it was more than just the COVID thing. That really was what she used as an excuse, right, Sam?
She said that half of her team was out, and I was told that there were three people that were actually out. Yeah, and they were like wardrobe assistants, you know, mm-hmm. anybody that could have been plugged into those roles, so that was not an issue at all. That was a smokescreen. And these days, if you need an excuse, if you say COVID, who's going to question?
That's right. That's correct.
It's a good one. It's a good excuse.
It's mean, though. That's very mean. I mean, we're talking about a lethal condition here, and she's using it to get out of a contract.
Is she ever going to come back?
Caesars doesn't want her back.
No, they don't want her back.
They have undergone so much PR damage from the situation.
Yep.
And when you think about the fact that shows right now are really hurting, not big production shows, all shows.
Talk a little bit about that, because the attendance at shows is really, really
it's
down.
It's frightening.
And well, you saw some pictures of, what was it, Mysterio?
Yeah,
Mysterio,
I took those.
Yeah, with totally empty.
It was, I've never seen anything like this before. Uh-huh. And Mysterio is one of it's the lowest price Cirque du Soleil show in town. And with people having issues with their budget, you would think they would gravitate towards something that was less expensive, easy to get to,
and a great show.
Established.
Don't
absolutely.
You think we're getting tired of these Cirque du Soleil shows?
Well, when there was talk that they weren't going to come back at all because they were $1 billion in debt and they needed to restructure, people really wanted them back. But what they say and what they actually do don't always pan out for dollars and cents.
Well, if you're a magician or a Cirque du Soleil employee, you can work in Vegas.
Well, yeah, there's still plenty of
all the magicians.
We're going to take a break right now. Hey, Hal, we're going to take a break, come back to you. But going into the break, I've got a cut here that you recorded. I don't know when. Let's see. Superstition I found on YouTube. Do you know about your own songs?
No.
Here's you.
This is me.
Doing Superstition. And I think it was, what's the year on there, Mark? 2012?
Yeah.
2012, a while back. Oh, by the way, say hello to Mark Thomas, our studio producer. There he is.
Hi, Mark.
Let's go take a break. We'll take it out with Hal Savar and Superstition.
Spokesperson for New Mail Medical Center is answering questions from the media. Take a listen.
Yeah, many men have tried pills with no success, or they have had bad side effects. What makes New Mail any different?
Our treatments can work even when pills have failed. Next question.
What if someone is diabetic, has high blood pressure, or even had prostate surgery?
We've treated tens of thousands of patients just like that, and with great success. Next question.
And for men who don't have ED, can New Mail still help them be at their best?
New Mail offers low T treatments, peptide therapy, medically managed weight loss, even treatments for hair loss.
Call now at 702-919-0609 or visit online at numale.com. Call New Mail Medical Center at 702-919-0609. That's 702-919-0609. New Mail, the experts in men's sexual health.
There's a child in Kenya, or Sierra Leone, or India, or Bolivia, who you could connect with. And through Child Fund, it's possible. We may be thousands of miles apart, but we can still connect with each other. And when we do, we make things better. We connect children all around the world with what they need to grow up healthy, educated, and safe. That's what Child Fund is about. Together, we co-create, support, and sustain connections that lead to greater well-being for millions of children who live in poverty worldwide, and their families, and their communities, and their countries, and you. Join us. Together, we can make the world a better place. Two small worlds at a time. His and yours. Visit childfund.org to learn more.
We're back on the Las Vegas Rocks Radio Show, AM 670. I'm your host, Ron Garrett, along with my guest tonight, Tom Hillery, Neil Portnoy. Hal Savar and the great Sam Novak. We were talking with Sam about Adele. We'll come back to that in a minute, but I want to say hello to Hal.
I can finally make my big announcement that I'll be taking over Adele's show.
Well, you're the lead singer of the Hal Savar band. Yeah. Your show is a live jukebox band.
Yep.
And we'll find out what that means in a minute. You're from Philadelphia, is that right?
Mm-hmm. Yep.
Okay, good, good. Let's see. You went to Bay State Business College. I do some research.
I was all over the place.
I've got a real hoarse voice today, huh?
Yeah, it's still a good voice. It's a radio voice.
It's a radio voice, all right.
Very manly.
You sing 185 songs. I think it's more than that, right?
A lot more than that.
Yeah, the last time you wrote something about yourself, it was up to 185.
I just haven't written anything in a while.
That was in 2017. It's up to over 200 now.
He's up over 400,
over
actually.
Over 400, yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, and you are a rock star, you say, and you're passionate about the business. You love movies. You never sleep.
It's true.
All that you know, you like true. Video games. What's your favorite video game?
Wow. I haven't had time for a lot of video games lately because of the kids and stuff. I have a PlayStation 4 at home, you know. I like those games that it's like cinematic. It's like you're playing a movie. You know?
Okay. Well, I'm reading your own press release here. And you're a fun guy with a big heart.
Yeah, that's all that's true. Yeah.
Yeah. So tell us why that is.
I haven't been beat down enough yet. No.
Give us a little story about the Hal Savar band and what you do, Hal. I know you're working tonight up at the up in Mount Charleston.
Yeah, yeah.
So you got to get the hell out of here.
I talked to them.
You told me you'd be late.
They're good. They love me.
How long did it take you to get up there?
I mean, from here, probably like
an hour,
45 minutes.
Yeah, 45 minutes.
If there's no traffic.
And no snow.
No snow. Yeah. So you work up there, but give us a little rundown of Hal Savar and some of the things you've done.
So I moved here in 2002, and I was only doing original music. And at the time, I met Amir Bayan, who is a founding member of Kool & the Gang. And he helped produce my first album, and I was only doing original music. And kind of put a band together and started like playing my own stuff. And then some things happened, as they do, and everything kind of fell through. And I didn't know what to do because I was young, and there was no plan. And I started looking at all the cover bands around town. And all of them were very similar. They were all kind of like cookie-cutter, like, dance bands. They'd all wear the same color. And it was like, tonight's like blue night. Everybody wear blue, you know?
Motown.
And I was like, I don't know if I want that. I wanted to do something different. And I wandered into Dueling Pianos. And, you know, as a broke 23-year-old kid, I just was enamored with
now
the tip
jar. Now you're a broke
40-year-old man.
my, how we've grown.
Yeah, it's crazy. But I thought that Dueling Piano request thing was really cool. And I kind of adopted that. And eventually started a band with Nina DiGregorio, who played violin for us. Lannis Hughes, who was the drummer for Rick James, was our drummer. And Dave King played piano and guitar and stuff like that. And we just took requests. So as people left the band, I would continue to learn songs. And now I play solo. I play with the band wherever they want me. And also I have original music that I'm still working on and doing a lot of stuff. It's
some of the
stuff.
Places you've worked here in town.
Oh my gosh!
Yeah, name them all.
Planet Hollywood.
We have an hour to kill.
Because my thought process was always like, I'll take whatever. I'll just want to get in front of people. So the Palms Casino, everything from the Palms Casino to Planet Hollywood Casino. We were the house band for about a year and a half, five nights a week. Margaritaville, Tropicana, Westgate Hotel, Rio. There was a period of time where we were playing a lot of Caesar's properties, but also we played, you know, like little Irish pubs, like McMullen's Irish Pub and the Old Dubliner at Lake Las Vegas. And I played corporate parties, you know, for like real estate companies and weddings and basically like anywhere and everywhere. I joke around, I'm like a musical superhero. I go where I'm needed.
How many members are your band?
It depends what people want.
Mostly you do it. You could do it by yourself, though.
Tonight at Mount Charleston, it'll just be me with an acoustic guitar. If there's a budget for
It's not the place that burned down, is it?
No, it's the other place.
Because it's kind of cold out.
Luckily.
You know, next to the fireplace.
It would have been bad.
That's not there anymore.
But yeah, I've been in Vegas, you know, being a professional musician and stuff for 15 years or so. And then I did something different this past summer, which was I went on tour with my original music and brought my kids, and we shot a docuseries that we were trying to get picked up by, like, Netflix.
Nice.
Now, yeah. you went to school in near Boston, right?
I did, yeah.
So I'm going to turn it over here to my agent Boston, Mr. Neil Portnoy.
I'm from Worcester. I grew up in Worcester, and Ron was talking about Framingham High.
Yeah,
it's so you were right near Doug Flutie at Natick High.
That's right, yeah.
So I know
Doug
that
Flutie? Yep.
Doug Flutie went to Natick High, yeah. So Route 9.
Who's a naked guy?
Natick High.
Oh, Natick High.
Has Tammy ordered those ear things
there,
yet?
Sam. You perked right up when I said that.
I was wondering whether Tammy had ordered those aids for the ears, but never mind. Natick High, Framingham High used to play against each other in all the sports.
Right.
So you were on Route 9. You went Route 9 and Route 30.
That's right.
I know it very well.
I went, and then I went to Mass Bay Community College, which they like. Kind of joking.
Are you a Red Sox fan?
Route 9 High. No, I'm from Philly, so I'm like.
Oh, you like the Philly?
I like all the horrible Philly teams. I love
Citizens Park. I've been there.
Well, you know, the Eagles played great baseball. Oh, that's not.
Yeah, but they weren't supposed to. That was the problem.
They weren't supposed to.
They were a football team.
Oh, is that what it was? Now, Hal, you brought your guitar.
I did, yeah.
Yeah, well, don't put it out. Bring it out yet. We're going to come back to you here. And
cool.
Have you seen? You're going to sing live on the air with your. Yeah?
Yeah, definitely.
Can I do backup?
Sure.
What do you play?
Nothing. I'm one of four people in Vegas that cannot carry a tune.
Just give them a triangle.
Oh, five. Okay.
Five. Right. I can't either. Sam, can you sing?
I can.
I can play a little guitar.
I can.
A little guitar or a full size?
No, full size little guitar, yeah. I know my chords, but, you know, yeah. Then I wake up.
So let's go backstage with Sam a little further here.
All right.
You have any information for us of something that's going to happen in Vegas real soon? No. Okay. I'll try. I'm thinking of any kind of inside information.
Well, you're
that you can't tell, that you can't say.
I can't say.
Well, okay. Sam, that you can't say it, but if people want to follow what you're writing, how do they do that?
Oh, geez, just go to Vegas411.com.
Well, you've got a lot of things going here. So I'm looking at this right now on your bio. Your Vegas Uncensored had over a million readers.
Yep.
Vegas Unfiltered.
Unfiltered, I mean.
Right.
That's a good one, too, Uncensored, isn't it?
Well,
in this town,
Unfiltered referred to my mouth.
Vegas Unfiltered, and that's your mouth, right? Because I read some of your articles today.
Oh, I'm so sorry.
And half of those you can't read on the radio. But they're all insightful and very to the point.
I want to commend you on your language here on the radio show today, because earlier when you walked in the door, no, Sam, can't say that word. No, Sam, no. Okay, I'll try to behave.
So how'd you take that to Vegas... Unfiltered, and you turned that into Vegas 411?
Actually, somebody turned it in for me.
Tell us about your whole thing here.
I used to work for a website called Vegas Chatter, which was part of the Condé Nast Travel Network.
Mm-hmm.
Big site. It was probably the biggest Vegas website at the time. And I was living in Florida, and I got contacted by the editor there to come aboard as a writer because they liked my tourist perspective.
You were in Fort Lauderdale?
At the time, I was living around Melbourne, Cocoa Beach.
Okay. Cocoa Beach, that's nice there.
So it was a great excuse to come out to Vegas all the time, hit the shows, hit the restaurants, go back and then write about them. And after a while, moved to Oregon and got closer to Vegas.
What city in Oregon did you
move? Salem, the capital.
Salem.
Mm-hmm. Still have a house up there.
Have you ever been to Coos Bay?
Yes.
Is it a nice place?
Yes.
Yeah.
There's nothing aside from the politics that isn't great about Oregon.
Yeah, well, Coos Bay has a very low
what's the word?
Cost of living.
So you're taking the RV up there when you and Tammy go traveling?
We're going to do it.
That's why you asked the question.
I did. And we might take it right up there before that because we found out that it's a nice place and the cost of living is very low.
But go in the summertime because it's even in the spring, it's really cool there.
Really? It's like San Francisco.
Well, I did. I checked the weather. It's the same temperature all year round almost, from between 45 and 60.
See, that's cool.
Something like that. It's right on the beach.
You will not get a tan.
There's no beach.
But Sam, you're also reviewing restaurants. You're doing a lot of that stuff as well.
Yes. In fact, I was just over at Olive's over at Virgin last night interviewing their GM.
Are you partnering with the gentleman that I met the other night at Tuscany?
The gentleman, the contract worker?
I don't know what he does.
Which one are you talking
about? The one with the accent from Australia.
Oh, the one that was my companion?
Yes.
Oh, no, not partnering. We're just colleagues.
But I'm partnering with the writing is what I'm saying. Are you writing? Because he covers a lot of the culinary, doesn't he?
Yes. But okay. He does that on his own. We're not affiliated in any way. All
right. Yeah. Who's your partner in this business?
I have a silent partner.
Did I find his name here? I think I did.
I hope you didn't.
Where is
it? And I'm out of a job.
I'll find it. Clay Bushes.
Oh, that is one of my proteges.
Ah. So what are you teaching him?
How
to write, how to get around.
Actually, I don't need to teach Clay anything because really? Clay's more colorful than I am.
Has he worked with you at?
Yes, since I came aboard, I've added two more writers. We've got Clay Bushes, who's more outlandish with the entertainment and the dining, and then we've got Gunnar McDixie, who is like the expose columnist.
Gunnar McDixie.
Yeah, it's a pseudonym because he's a former dancer here in Vegas.
Mm-hmm.
I thought he was a NASCAR rider.
Perfect name. Now he's a UPS driver.
We're going to take a break right now. Come back.
Story.
Okay, I love these stories.
It's a great story.
We're going to take a break right now. We're going to come back, and while we're on break, we're going to get Hal to open up and get his guitar out, and we'll get that ready to go. And I'm coming back. We'll talk a little bit to Tom about his latest movie, which is Honey Trap. So we're going to take it out to break with the real Adele. And maybe we won't play the whole thing. And this is easy on me.
There ain't no gold.
Time for a weather update. It's a temperature. It could rain or not. It's either hot or cold. So wear a jacket or don't. Anyway, good luck.
Unclear information isn't helpful, which is why when your car needs repair, head to Meineke Car Care Centers. With Meineke e-inspection, we'll send photos and technician notes straight to your phone, telling you what should be fixed and why. Get up to $50 off brake pads or shoes and a free lifetime warranty. Meineke, doing car care right. At participating locations, terms and conditions apply.
Unlike other health concerns, mental illness is not always easy to see. Depression won't show up on an eye chart. And you can't measure it on your bathroom scale. Sorting out a mental health concern is not something to attempt on your own. You won't find a bipolar disorder by looking at a thermometer. Like many other health conditions, help for mental illness takes professional diagnosis and treatment. Anxiety won't just go away under a stick-on bandage. So the sooner you seek treatment, the better. If you or a loved one has a mental health concern, don't go it alone. Find out what to do. For 24-hour free and confidential information and treatment referral, call 1-800-662-HELP. Learn more at samhsa.gov/support. That's samhsa.gov/support.
Roxanne Watson is on a mission to have more people sign up as organ, eye, and tissue donors. What drives her? Roxanne received a heart transplant made possible by an organ donor.
I decided that day to devote myself to signing up the most people in the United States. That's my goal.
Now she's a powerful force for good. What could you make possible as an organ, eye, and tissue donor? Leave behind the gift of life. Go to organdonor.gov. U.S. Department of Health and Human Services, Health Resources and Services Administration.
And we're back on AM 670 KMZQ, the Las Vegas Rocks Radio Show. I'm Ron Garrett, your host. And our executive producer and movie maker is up next to tell us about his latest movie that he's finally going to get made. And it's called Honey Pot.
Trap. Honey Trap.
I like the word pot better than trap.
That appeals to you for some reason. I won't ask you why. Well, yeah, Honey Trap's a perfect example of a rapid-fire movie. It's only been in development for 12 years. That's fast, actually. But the company out in the UK, Jagged Edge, did such a great job on Looks Can Kill. I said, these guys know this stuff, so I've decided I'm also going to give them the job on Honey Trap. So Honey Trap, it's pretty good. Timing is good, actually, right now, because it's about a Russian girl who's actually a violin player, but she thinks she's a super spy. She finds out that her company is being threatened with an anti-piracy software program from the Bad Americans and decides she's going to go to the United States to the Technician and Artist Conference the TNA conference, where she's going to find the guys who represent.
We're
going
to send you to
with all music.
You know, I'm going to send you.
Us
I'm going to send you to the Ukraine with that accent and see if you can help us out with Putin.
Put him on the border.
So when she gets there, she meets Christopher Ingersoll Anderson. You get the initials right. Who's a great protector.
CIA.
You got it, man.
Took me a minute.
Yeah. It's subtle, Ron. It's subtle. That's why you watch sit through the movie. So her name is Inosanka. Her name means innocence, of course. You know, she's like half dressed all the time because she's too innocent to put on too many clothes. And she's convinced she's going to ingratiate herself to Christopher and make him fall madly in love with her and hand her this anti-piracy
software program.
Well,
now we don't have to see the movie. Thanks,
oh,
Tom.
No, yes, you have to see the movie.
Oh, okay.
You didn't think I was going to give away the twist ending, did you?
No, don't do that. what
but
is
that's
it?
The theme of the movie. You got to buy the movie to find out, Ron.
Did Adele call in when you were making? No, I'm only kidding.
No, with Adele, you're doing great. Keep doing it over there.
Great job by Dana.
Yeah.
I'll say that again. She did a good job. Anyway. Yep. And what about some of your other projects? You're also an inventor. You've got a patent on a couple of things?
Oh, 3 patents issued so far and 4 pending. Mm-hmm. Yeah, the latest one we're working on is the smoke alarm system, which instead of having the changeable battery up in the ceiling, it has it mounted in the wall, like at the height of a light switch. So it's basically the world's first handicapped accessible smoke alarm.
Mm-hmm.
So that I'm really proud of, working with some people to find out if this is, you know, correct for Nevada building, if there's also a way of putting it into existing systems to modify existing systems in existing houses. I think it's really going to help a lot of people because many, many people die every year because their smoke alarms aren't working because they didn't change the batteries. And it's dangerous to change a battery.
Is there another movie after Honey Trap?
Well, the next one that's written ready to shoot is called Student Bodies.
Looks Can Kill, Honey Trap,
Student Bodies.
There's a theme here.
You get the idea, right?
Yeah.
Well,
Disney knockoffs.
Yeah. Disney knockoffs.
Yeah, Minnie Mouse goes mad, you know, that sort of
That's
thing.
That's right. Well, they redress Minnie Mouse, by the way. She no longer can wear a dress.
No, what if
now
she's
in a pantsuit.
Oh, in combat boots?
Yeah, the woke crowd got to Disney and...
Hi, I'm Minnie Mouse! You know, something like that.
And now she's wearing a blue pantsuit.
A pantsuit, and Donald Duck can still expose his red.
Donald Duck has no clothes on.
Well, Donald Duck's got the right idea. Show your best side.
Thanks, Tom. I appreciate it. Sure. Let's turn our attention to Mr. Savar. Okay, Hal. What do you got? First of all, it's a nice guitar.
Thanks. This is the first big boy guitar that I ever bought. And then somebody got really drunk when we were playing at O'Shea's Casino in like 2011 and fell on it. And it completely broke. And then I put it away with my dreams for a long time.
With your dreams.
Yeah. Okay. And then my daughter was going crazy during the pandemic. And we made a little fort for her in the house.
Yeah.
And my fiance ordered this crazy wallpaper. And I was putting it up on the wall. And I thought, maybe I can stick it to this old guitar and just see what it would. And now I use this guitar again.
Let's hear what it sounds like.
Okay.
What are you going to sing?
So this song's called Next Year.
Next Year.
Dry your tears, don't you cry. Everything's gonna be alright. Standing strong for you and me. It's not what we want, but what we need. Maybe next year everything is gonna change. Cause time be glad that nothing stays the same. Maybe next year. Maybe next year. You know too many that lost their time. You lost yourself, held down inside.
Sometimes you can't hold back the pain. Don't let the world drive you insane. Maybe next year everything is gonna change. This time be glad that nothing stays the same. Maybe next year. Maybe next year.
Thank you, Hal. We're going to go to a break right now. What a great song. What's the name of it again?
Next Year.
Next Year. I figured that out. We're going to take a break right now.
Both were prosecutors in the Clark County District Attorney's Office, each with 25 years of experience. One was chief of the Special Victims Unit. The other, chief of the Homicide Unit. Both dedicated. Both respected. Together, they are Craig Hendricks and Frank Como. The Vegas Dream Team for criminal defense you need in your corner. Call 702-222-9999 or visit VegasDreamTeam.com, a division of DeCastro Verde Law Group.
The future depends on teachers. Every day, teachers are shaping our tomorrows, starting their students on journeys that will change the course of history. Right now, in a classroom somewhere in the United States, there's a teacher inspiring a future scientist will make preventing pandemics their life's work, sharpening the mind of an aspiring environmentalist who will help combat climate change, and generating possibilities for a student who will be the first in their family to graduate college. It all starts with teachers who meet challenges with creativity, who reinvent education for the future, who work towards a school system that lifts up every child, regardless of race, income, or zip code, and who enable the full potential of our students, our communities, and our country. Explore a career that leaves a legacy you can be proud of. Shape the future. Teach. Learn more and receive free support at teach.org.
11-year-old Hazel lives in a place that's rich in many things, but not money. Her job is to play, grow, and learn. But for kids like her in the world's poorest places, poverty gets in the way. Child Fund works in 24 countries to make sure children like Hazel grow up healthy, educated, self-sufficient, and safe. Why? Because Child Fund knows the promise inside every child is greater than the poverty around them. Learn more at childfund.org.
And we're back on the Las Vegas Rocks Radio Show. I'm Ron Garrett, your host, on AM 670 KMZQ. Hal, that was terrific. Thank you so much. We appreciate that. Thanks for bringing your guitar around.
Well done.
Well done. I'm going to switch now to our buddy Sam. Sam, you were recently on Inside Edition on TV. I have the clip from that. Those of you on Facebook Live, watch the video screen, the computer screen, on the right-hand side, right by Neil. And here is a clip from Inside Edition.
Meanwhile, we're hearing reports out of Las Vegas that Adele canceled her residency, not because of COVID, but because she was unhappy with the set. Local reporters say Adele demanded an elaborate spectacle and hated what her designers built.
She was demanding that they would replace this entire array of expensive curtains with another color, different types of rhinestones, and from what I understand, that was done three different times and she still wasn't satisfied.
They even built a lake on stage.
She just called it an old pond. She thought that it looked beneath her.
It could be a year before Adele's concerts are rescheduled. In the meantime, country star Keith Urban to the rescue. He's taking over for her.
All right, there you go. Now you have a lot of good information. How'd that all come about?
Oh, it was strange.
Getting on TV.
I'm a writer. I write from home. And I was up until like 4 o'clock in the morning that particular day working on things. I woke up maybe around 9 and I had all these emails from Inside Edition, which...
How'd they know to get a hold of you?
good question. Somebody here in town who is a local cameraman for them must follow my one of my pages.
Mm-hmm.
So I've been posting different things as I was hearing them, and think some things that, you know, alluding to that I couldn't discuss yet. And so I somehow they connected to me, and I'm waking up with my hair all over the place and puffy eyes, and haven't gotten my coffee yet, trying to squint at these emails, and then my phone's ringing. And they were wanting to discuss all this for to go on the air, and I said, "Well, okay, you know, where do you want me to go? What do you want me to do?" And they're like, "Oh, we need to do this right away. Can we get you on the air by 10 o'clock?" And it's 9:20 in the morning.
My goodness!
So
where did they shoot it? Where did you have to go?
Well, they ended up doing it as a Zoom shoot.
You would have never known it watching it on TV.
It looked good.
It looked very good.
I saw it, the original. I went and got the clip, but I actually saw the actual show.
Getting that situated was chaos within itself because, as you mentioned earlier, I have cats. And I normally when I
it
do
was it, a great play. I loved it on Broadway.
Terrible. No.
Oh, you mean real cats.
Real cats.
It's like the feline 101 Dalmatians. Just go to Sam's place.
In my house, right. Yeah.
How many do you have?
Yes, that's a good question.
How many?
I'm not going to answer that.
All right,
they're all special needs. I'm not a hoarder or anything like that.
But more than you,
more than the standard household,
more than normal.
Right.
We'll leave it there.
Yeah, just leave.
Can
it
you
there.
Name all their names like Ron Ken with his relative from Florida?
Oh, I can rattle them all. Plus my deceased ones and the ones that I've.
Unbelievable.
Yeah.
Yeah, you've got the urns all around as well, right?
That is right. Yes.
Pretty sweet.
Oh, okay.
So anyway,
then what happened?
So I got in the shower, shaved. Tried to do something with my hair, under eye gel, because, like I said, I was all puffy. And
Lexiderm?
No.
Oh, you don't use that?
It's the cheap stuff that I get. Stuff that I get from...
We got half a word out. Whoa! It's all right. Yeah, half a word.
Okay, thank you.
Half a word. It's all right.
I set up my laptop in my office, shooed the cats out, and the lighting wasn't right because they were doing like a quick...
Mm-hmm.
They said, you have to go to another room. So I go to my dining room. Sun's coming in. She says, perfect. We get started. The interview is rolling. We spoke for probably 15, 20 minutes. And one of my cats hopped up on the table and started rubbing her cheek on my laptop. We're trying to reach around and
get the kitty cat
down on the floor. And I think she did come around and get her face into the camera, but they just clipped that all out. So understandably, they used about 40 seconds out of a 15, 20 minute chat. The cat was not in it. She was very angry with me the next day.
The cat? Did she have something to say to you about that?
Well, of course. She scratched me.
Has anything come of that now? Has any leads come from your appearance on a national show?
Just hometown fame. Other than that, nothing. I mean, I can't even get a free Big Mac. No.
You can't?
No.
Go for a double-double.
So speaking of hometown fame, the magnificent one, Neil, is having another Wham! Event.
At Portnoy Gallery.
At Portnoy Gallery. What's happening there?
February 8th from 6:30 to 9:30. Wine, art, and music with the fabulous Joelle Righetti.
Wow.
Joelle in the Gypsies.
Amazing.
And she'll be performing at the gallery from 7 to 9. There's a Facebook page. You can go to Eventbrite. Sign up. It's $20 to get in. Enjoy the artwork, enjoy the wine, and enjoy the incredible talent that we have in this city, one of which is Joelle Righetti.
And you're going to be doing this every month now?
Every month. Second Tuesday of
second
every month.
Second Tuesday. Yep. So that's an interesting thing. Go hear some music.
Read a limb in the third month.
And enjoy some refreshments.
Sure to show up.
Yep.
Oh, they do. We had a huge crowd.
The first one we did in January, we had Joey Melotti and Miss Monet. And we had 80 people at the gallery. We were the only sold-out show that night in Vegas.
How did Wayne Newton do on his opening night, Sam?
I actually haven't heard.
Oh.
And that means probably was pretty low-key.
I saw some pictures on Facebook. Do you see anything, Neil, about
I didn't
Wayne?
See anything. I saw him when he was over at Bally's.
Yeah, well, and so did I.
Listen, it's
times.
A tremendous show. He doesn't sing anymore. He has trouble
well,
with
actually,
singing.
He does. He does.
Well, if that's what you'd like
I
to call
saw the,
it.
I saw the video, and he opens up with CeCe Ryder.
Right.
Doesn't sound as good as he used to.
Correct.
But it doesn't matter.
It doesn't matter. It's a
it
living legend.
It doesn't matter. This is Wayne Newton.
That's correct.
And he can sing any way he damn well pleases.
That's right.
What do you think about the venue they have him in now?
I haven't seen it. I know that it's not a big venue. I think it's, what, 100 and somewhat?
It's really, really small. I was there at Flamingo last week to review Piff the Magic Dragon show, which they moved into the Donnie and Marie show, and that's where they put Wayne is in his old theater.
How big is that theater?
The Donnie Marie Theater?
No, the one that Wayne's in. How many seats?
It's a small cabaret. I mean, they could.
Well, his show is up close and personal anyway.
It is, but you when know. You think about it, Wayne Newton's in a tiny little venue, and you've got a man wearing a Godzilla costume in the big grand Flamingo showroom.
With a dog. He's got a little dog with him.
How about you, Hal? What is your next appearance other than the Mount Charleston? Did you work at the Copper Keg? Is that a little spot that you can go to?
I've never done this yet, but this starts this Thursday, actually.
Thursday.
Where are they located? Where is it?
Right across the street from Harley Davidson on basically like Sahara and Rainbow.
Oh.
By the Harley Davidson. Oh, okay. I know.
I'm opening it up to other musicians that want to come and jam with me.
Is it going to be like an open mic?
No. I'll be playing the requests, but if like... Say somebody plays trumpet and they want to get up and play with me when people request the songs.
Mm-hmm.
Like, I'm opening it up to all my musician friends.
Well, that's great for, you know, we always get, Sam, you'll agree with me, we get new talent in this city all the time.
Absolutely.
You know, guys, you know, with the genre of what they're doing in the entertainment capital of the world, they feel like when they get here, they're going to make it big and they're going to be, you know, entertainer. You got to... Play
your dues.
Might be a great opportunity for someone to say, look, I'm a trumpet player. You know, I play violin. Can I jump up for a couple of songs?
You don't get many call-ups for instrument players. All these open mic type of things. It's always singer.
Yep.
Once in a while, you get a guy like Ken Johnson. He gets up there and he's amazing with his saxophone and so on. There's a lot of good players out there, but he's well-known for that.
Well, you've got Isaac Tubbs.
Joey Malotti.
Kevin Molinex.
Yes, a lot of great people get a chance.
I have to wonder if that's where all of our tourists are going. They're discovering all these places like this and staying out of the big showrooms.
Well, they're hitting the Spaghetti Circuit.
The Spaghetti Circuit, is that
what it's called? Yeah, Siena, Italian American Club, Prosecco's, Chianti Dolce, Spaghetti-O's. The list is forever.
It's my favorite.
You know, we no longer have a spaghetti bowl here. No. You know, on the highways, right. We have it in the clubs.
In the clubs.
Smart.
That's the way it works. Tom, what do you got coming up next on your schedule?
Well, Sam's got me inspired over here for another thriller called The House of Cats, subtitled otherwise The Cat House.
I hope it's going to be in 3D.
3D.
3D House of Cats.
44D, whichever way you want, buddy.
Okay.
Tom, this is a radio show here. You know.
It is indeed. Oh, we're talking about movies.
Okay, movies. That's right. Okay. That's okay. So, Neil.
Yes.
What's going on with Frank, Sammy, and Dean? I understand they have a new home.
The new home of Frank, Sammy, and Dean is Portnoy Gallery.
That's right.
We have expanded to 3,200 square feet now at the gallery. And a lot of the entertainers in town are on the Portnoy Wall of Honor. It's an honor to get on that wall. Sam, you're on that wall.
I am.
With Muscles.
Muscles.
With Muscles, yeah.
Stripped out of the bare essentials.
Yeah. So we're getting ready to take the end of the show here. We're going to have a few last words, Sam.
Just check out Vegas411.com.
How do they do that?
You go online and you type in Vegas411.com.
Okay, easy enough. I'm still not computer literate.
No, you just learned.
I just learned. I need hearing aids. I can't see. I need hearing aids. Al, you're going to head up to Mount Charleston now?
I'll be at Mount Charleston. My band will be over at the Stratosphere and the Remix Lounge on Valentine's Day. And we'll be around.
Thank you, Hal.
Closing
words, I've got just 30 seconds.
Listen, I draw. Check out PortnoyGallery.com. Stop by Portnoy Gallery, 1537 West Oakey, and view the artwork on the walls.
Thank you, Sam Novak. Thank you, Hal Savar. Thank you, Neil Portnoy. And again, thank you, Tom Hillery.
Support your local artists.
That's right. And make movies in Vegas. Thank you all for listening to the Las Vegas Rocks Radio Show. Our mission is to promote, motivate, and support local entertainers, and all things Vegas. Thank you to my guests and to our audience for making us the most watched live entertainment radio show in Las Vegas. And as always, a tip of the hat to Las Vegas Entertainment Ambassador, the late Tony Sacca. Tony said Las Vegas rocks, and he was right. Las Vegas rocks and always will. I'm Ron Garrett. Thank you, and good night.
Vegas night.